101 from Hamish Marshall gave Gloucestershire the edge after day two against Glamorgan. Gloucestershire resumed on 62 for 3, with Marshall's cut shot in good fettle early on. Hankins was giving Marshall good support as the fourth wicket stand kept growing. Marshall sent one to the cow corner boundary to bring up his 50, and not long afterwards the stand went past three figures. Gloucestershire were 139 for 3 at lunch, but with only 19 runs added after the interval, Hankins was out, caught by Wallace off Wagg for 43 from 152 deliveries. Marshall was joined by Mustard, and the pair added 56 for the fifth wicket to put Gloucestershire on the brink of a first innings lead. Marshall dominated the scoring between the pair and looked particularly comfortable against the Glamorgan spin attack. Marshall reached his 100 in the mid-afternoon, a superb effort that held the Gloucestershire first innings together. Mustard was out for 11 from 42 balls, caught by Bragg off Hogan. Hogan claimed the big scalp of Marshall, out LBW for 101. Taylor played aggressively, hitting three fours in the 13 runs he managed before departing, caught by Selman in the slips off Van der Gooten. Miles and Payne were the new combination, and in the early evening they put together a useful 8th wicket stand. The pair added 60 runs at comfortably more than 4 and over. Miles was out for 34, caught by Wagg off Carlson. Payne and Shaw were the new pairing and added an unbroken 56, scored at only just more than 2 runs and over, Payne dominating the scoring between the pair. Gloucestershire had reached 347 for 8 by stumps on day 2, Payne 58 not out, Shaw unbeaten on 17 off 62 balls. Gloucestershire holding a valuable first innings lead of 127 runs and counting, with just 2 first innings wickets remaining.